There are some common misconceptions that we come across throughout life. I remember when I was growing up, one of those was if you cut a worm in half, it makes two worms. I don't know where that came from, but that was one of them. The other one from Scripture is that on Christmas, as we often think of that, that three kings came to Jesus. And that is another one of those that we do not find within Scriptures, but as we see it from a song. And there's another one today in Luke chapter 20. Stay tuned. In Luke chapter 20, the Sadducees, at the end of the chapter, or the middle there, approach Jesus with a question. The Sadducees, as the chapter, as we read in verse 27, it talks about the fact that they do not believe in the resurrection, and yet they come to ask Jesus a question about the resurrection. Now, that in and of itself should throw up some red flags to us, and this is a little bit ironic. Why would you ask Jesus about something that you yourself don't believe in? But yet, their sole purpose is to make him out to be a fool before those around them. But Jesus indulges them, and he answers their question. And theirs is about marriage. In 1954, the movie Seven Brides for Seven Brothers came about. In this particular passage, we're not talking about seven brides but for seven brothers, but we're talking about seven brothers for one wife. It was following a Levitical. Part of the Levitical law, or part of the law, and some statements there, and that's what they were questioning about. And Jesus presents something that's very different. You know, when we talk about heaven, and that's what he's actually addressing here, there's often some common misconceptions, aren't there? One of those is that is we often think of the Hollywood or the cartoonish theme of little baby angels with harps floating around on clouds with wings. As angelic, we think of becoming angels. Jesus says something very different, though, and he references that with this day versus that day. Oftentimes, I think we try to think of heaven as something better, as in the sense of it is this age but better. And Jesus says, no, things are completely different in the age to come when it comes to heaven. And he talks about that here, specifically referencing marriage. He talks about the fact that there will no longer be marriage. He says, we will be, in a sense, and Matthew communicates this as well, that we will be like angels in the fact that they will neither marry nor be given in to marriage. In fact, they can no longer die, verse 36, because they are equal to angels and are sons of God, since they are sons of the resurrection. Now, he doesn't say that we become angels, but we're like them in a sense, and that we there is no longer marriage. It's interesting at the end of that section that they say, or the Luke makes this remark, for they did not dare any longer to ask him anything. They're asking about marriage. What they should have done is continue to ask questions, though, on the beginning of what he states in addressing this. He says this in verse 35, but those who were regarded as worthy to share in that age and in the resurrection from the dead, they should have asked this question, who is worthy? And of course, Luke makes that evident, not only in Luke, but also in the book of Acts, which he wrote as well. We can turn back to chapter 19 and the story about Zacchaeus, and where we see a man, a sinner, who is humbled, who recognizes who he is before the Lord, and Jesus pronounces his salvation. Undoubtedly, salvation is what? Those who are worthy are who? Are those who profess faith in Christ. And that's the question that needs to be answered for everyone today. Am I worthy even for heaven? We don't just get there by good works. We don't just get there by a baptism or some sayings or whatever it might be. Scriptures make it abundantly clear that salvation is only by faith in Christ alone, upon his finished work of the cross, trusting in that because he is the one who has made that bridge for us. To God. It's through faith in Him. The other thing is simply about heaven and the misconceptions that we often have. We're not just these floating little angels. There's things will be different. It's not going to be this age, thank goodness. It's not going to be this age just better. No, it's going to be something new, something significantly better. We read in Revelation that we're a place where there will be no more mourning or crying or death or pain. No more suffering. We will be face to face with God. And you know, in days like now, when times are confusing, when there is peril, when we see death, when we see suffering, we look forward to that day with hope. We look forward to that day when all things will be changed and made new. We don't want to be misconstrued about what that day is. It is much, much better when we will be with our Savior face to face. And as we live today, as we live these days here on this earth, still in the midst of a world plagued with sin, we look forward to that hope, but we're also reminded there are so many who are not worthy, who need that hope. And we're reminded of our mission to share the gospel. Let's be concerned about the eternity of those around us. And let's be concerned as well, again, about building up those within the church. We look forward to that day. Amen. And if you have not yet professed faith in Christ, please feel free to reach out to us. We would love to chat with you about that and the hope that can be yours in Christ Jesus. Until next time, friends, God bless.